Hey guys, so today I have a friend kind of video for you guys. This is not going to be a tutorial, it's not going to be a fashion video, it's not going to be anything related to makeup or beauty or fashion or anything like that. Today I want to share with you guys an experience that I had this morning, actually. Today is Sunday, at church. And I also want to share with you guys a message from God that came to me in the most weird and unexpected ways, and the fact that, so bear with me, this video is going to be a little choppy. It's going to be a little hard for me to get my thoughts together because I just feel like there's so much that I want to say, and it's so hard to put what I want to say into words. But I feel like a calling from God for me to share my story and my experience, because I know that He wants me to help somebody out there who's experiencing the same thing as I am. Where do I start? So first, let me start with, this is not going to be a production video. I'm barely gonna edit this video. I'm just going to speak my mind. This is going to be just me sitting here talking to you. You guys are my friends. I want to be able to connect with you guys at a different level that, you know, my beauty videos don't do, or like my fashion videos don't do, because that is only a small facet of who I am, and that's only a small piece of what you guys see from me. I am a human being. I have feelings. I go through good times and bad times. I am not unbreakable. I am not, you know, always positive, always happy. You know, I am human. I've never done a video like this where I'm so vulnerable. I feel like something is calling me to do this, and something is making me put myself out there, because I know that this video, this message is for the greater good. Sorry if you hear any noise or wind or birds chirping. This is just going to be a very kind of laid-back video. We're gonna talk heart to heart, like as if we were friends and we were just having a conversation. I guess I'll start with how I got to where I am now and what I'm experiencing. Past couple of months, I would say like the past 6 to 7 months, I've been feeling almost like I've been in a crut. I don't know if any of you guys have been there, where you just feel like, you know, you're not missing anything from your life, in the sense that you have the things that you want, you have accomplished the things that you want to accomplish, but you're still empty inside, and you still feel like you're incomplete and you're unfulfilled. I've had this feeling for quite a long time, and I've just been feeling unmotivated, undedicated, and just kind of lost in my own thoughts, drowning in so much negativity and drowning in so much influence of everything around me, and losing myself and losing what I truly believe in, and just losing what I'm really true to. I think it started happening sometime like around June or July of last year. It doesn't matter what happened, like what experience led me to feel that way. What matters is that I chose to feel that way. I chose to let the negativity affect me, and I chose to let it get to me. It got to me really bad, and you know, I spent a lot of time being negative, and you know, feel like there's so much weight on my shoulder, like this negative blanket on top of my shoulders that's so heavy, and I can't get it out. I can't lift it no matter what I do, what I try to do. You know, I'm reading self-help books, watching Tony Robbins, you know, reading The Chicken Soup for the Soul, hoping that something will kind of just click in my mind, like it once did when I read these books that are supposed to be self-help and things like that. Last year, I would say maybe like a year ago, a year and a half ago, I really, really, really did find God, and I found Him through prayer, and He found me when I was, you know, He kind of just showed up in my life, and I didn't know that I wanted Him in my life. He just kind of showed up. I've always been like a, I always believed in faith. I always believed in, you know, God, but I never knew the power of God and His love and, you know, His presence in my life and how that would change. When I found God at that point in time in my life, I literally just, my life changed. It changed for the better. Everything just started going really well for myself. Something happened last year where I just kind of went backwards, and I turned into the same old negative person that I've been. And you guys don't know this about me, but I had a pretty rough childhood, and I didn't always have a lot of things. My parents grew up very poor. They were immigrants who moved to Puerto Rico, and they were very poor. They had to work really hard. I didn't have a childhood because I had to work with my parents and help my parents out, and I have two younger sisters that I kind of helped raise. So I had to grow up pretty fast. I'm the oldest of three girls, and I had to grow up pretty fast, and I had to kind of learn to be independent really quickly. I never got to really experience life as a child and all that. And my mom, I love her. She's, you know, as great as a mom as one can ask. She provides for us. She takes care of us. But she is not the most positive person. So I've always had a lot of self-doubt in my life. I've always had a lot of negative energy in my life because people never thought I was good enough, or the people around me never thought I was good enough. So I kept thinking to myself, I'm not good enough. And my whole life I've been searching and trying to find something that will make me feel fulfilled and something that's going to make me feel like I matter, like I'm worth something. Because my whole life I just keep feeling that I'm not worthy of anything. And you know, it's a shitty feeling to feel, you know? You know, you just become your thoughts and you become the surrounding around you. Like I said, my whole life I've been just kind of trying to find something to fill a void. And back in like 2014, I found God, you know? And as cheesy and as crazy as this sounds, I found God. And He changed my life. That's when, you know, I found passion in my life and everything I did, and my life started just taking off. I had amazing success with my channel, at work, at my job. I had amazing success, and somewhere down the line, I lost it. Something happened in my life, that one event in my life happened, and I felt the negativity took over me, the overwhelming sensation of just not being good enough took over me, and I lost my connection with God. I lost touch with God, and I let the negativity get to me, and I let everything that's not important in this life get to me, which leads me to where I am today. Up until yesterday, I still had that 10,000 pound blanket on my shoulders of negativity and not feeling good enough and self-doubt, and it was on my shoulders. It's been on my shoulders, and it's this unexplainable weight. And any of you guys who, you know, maybe are sharing the same feelings as I am, you understand 100%. I just want to say, by the way, this video is meant to be a video to connect with you guys. So as I'm talking and as I am, you know, sharing these experiences with you, feel free to like leave comments and let me know if you can relate or connect, or your thoughts or how you're feeling, you know, what's going on in your life, how can I help you? Because I want this video to be a video where we can connect and we can connect each other. And I know I'm gonna get a lot of crap for this video because a lot of people don't believe in God. They don't believe in, you know, that God is real, that Jesus is real, and people just don't believe, because it's easier not to believe than to believe. Back to the story. If you guys follow me on Snapchat, then you know that yesterday I went to a gun shooting range, and you know, I shot a gun for the first time in my life. It was extremely exhilarating and it was so much fun. And on the way back from the gun shooting range in New Jersey, actually let me back it up a little bit. I'm sorry, I'm like all over the place in this video, but I never said this video is gonna be perfect. This past week, I've been really wanting to go to church. So the church that I go to is Hillsong in New York, and I've been there before. I've been there, you know, a couple years back. I've been there a couple times, but I never stuck to it. I would kind of go once in a while when I felt like I needed a lift. And every time I go, I feel great, you know, but you know, when you stop going, you kind of just like lose yourself in all of this stuff happening around you. So anyways, I haven't been back there in probably almost a year, or actually more than a year. And this past week, I have been wanting to go to church again. And I've been wanting to go because I felt like there was something was drawing me to go to church. Every other time that I said that before, I always never make it to church because something pops up, plans happen, things happen, work happens, and I never can make it. But this week I was like, oh yeah, I really want to go, I'm gonna go. And I somehow forgot about it throughout the week with like all this, all my stress of like work and stuff like that. So I forgot about it. But yesterday when I was coming back from the gun shooting range, I was in the car with my boyfriend. We were driving back. I was sitting in the passenger seat, you know, we were driving back and, you know, I was just taking out my Spotify. And if any of you guys have Spotify, there's like a little section for new releases. So I clicked on there, you know, just want to put some good music on or whatever. Usually all I see in the new releases is like Sia or Drake or, you know, like pop music. But yesterday, I saw the Hillsong Young and Free CD, or like the album, on that new release page. And I've never seen Hillsong in that page before. Like, for the longest time that I've had Spotify, I've never seen any Christian music pop up in that page. So if that wasn't a sign from God, I don't know what was. Took that as a sign that, all right, Yanni, you need to go to church tomorrow. No matter what happens, you have to get your ass to church. I made that commitment or whatnot. In my mind, you know, God's speaking to me. He's telling me, go to church. You need to be there. You need to go because there's something there for you. I immediately went on the Hillsong website and I wanted to check out what services they had. So apparently they have like three or four services a day. And the earliest one is at 10 o'clock in the morning. They have two locations, which one is Midtown and then one is downtown. One in Midtown is like at PlayStation Stadium or something in like Times Square, and the downtown one is in Irvin Plaza. At the moment, I'm like, well, which one should I go to? Because, you know, every service is different. Different pastors deliver different messages. You know, I don't know where God wants me to go. Right then and there, I just kind of said a prayer in my head and I just spoke to God and I said, God, I want you to tell me where you want me to be tomorrow for the message that you want me to receive. I just kind of said that and I kind of left it with him to have him guide me. And the craziest thing happened that I swear, like, sometimes you hear about it and you're like, what? That's not real. I was literally on my phone and, you know, I listened to the Hillsong, you know, album, and I was like, all right, I'm over it. And I went back to the new release page and I saw that, you know, Birdie, she had a new song. So I went and I clicked Birdie, and then I went into her little album page. And as I'm doing this, as I'm going on the Birdie album page, all I can visually see is Irvin. Everything I read, like, I was reading the title of the song and it said Irvin. And at that moment, I didn't know that my eyes were seeing something that was actually not even there. So I played the song, and as I played the song, you know, it shows up on the little monitor in the car, and I'm listening to the song, I'm like, oh, that's a great song. And as I look at the monitor, I realize the name of the song is not Irvin. There's no Irvin in any of the music or like the screen. There's no Irvin anywhere. So I'm like, all right, so where did I see Irvin? I went back to my phone, go back on Spotify, and I look at that page to see if I saw Irvin anywhere. I did not see Irvin anywhere on that page. Anywhere. God was telling me, go to Irvin Plaza tomorrow, 10 o'clock in the morning, first service. That moment, I think that was the craziest experience that I've had, where, you know, I'm asking God to show me where he wants to lead me, and he immediately, without hesitation, just led me to the right place. That was just crazy. So I'm like, all right, great. I'll be there tomorrow at Irvin Plaza. This morning, Sunday morning, I get up, and mind you, last night I went to sleep at like 3 o'clock in the morning, so I'm exhausted. I had to get up at like 7 to get to church in time. So I set my alarm clock and everything, and there was something this morning that was different than every other morning that I've had. Something just literally pulled me out of it. I do not know how to explain it. Something just literally, physically, just took me out of bed without me even trying. I got out of bed, I brushed my teeth, I got ready, and I went to church. Never experienced something like that. Usually, you know, I have to drag myself, like, wake myself up, like, snooze a couple of times. Okay, I ain't gonna lie, I did snooze a couple of times, but once I was up to go, something just kind of like took over me and just took me. Goosebumps as I'm telling you guys this. So I go to church and I start listening to the church, to the service, and to the message the pastor had to say. And the message he had today was what he titled No Ordinary Love. As I am sitting there, or actually standing, and listening to the service and what this pastor is saying about, you know, we go our whole life unfulfilled, feeling empty, feeling lost, feeling just unworthy of a lot of things, I literally felt like God was speaking to me and acknowledging my pain and acknowledging what I was going through. And he led me there so that I could hear the message he had to say. As I was standing there and I was listening to this message, the pastor was kind of just explaining to us how, I cannot even put it into good words of how he explained this, but see, this is where it gets hard, because it's hard to deliver a message when you felt it so deep inside of you, that it's, and it's so large and it's so big that it just doesn't fit into words, but I'm gonna try.
And it's amazing there that we can actually go through our life where we can say, God love, I love God, I love God, God loves me, but everything that is reflected isn't that. I pray that my life is more like a documentary. I pray that our life as a church, as we go out on a Monday, as we leave here Sunday, and the worship is great, the word, it probably could have been better. But we go out on a Monday, and we wake up, and we just go, you know what? Because of how much God loves me, I'm just going to live out a life of love. That doesn't mean perfect, because here's the thing, is if you watch documentaries, and I love them, you realize the documentary isn't about perfect, it's about real. Hence it be called a documentary. I pray that people can look at my life and they don't see perfection. In fact, they'll never see perfection. But I pray that they're seeing me live out the highs and lows. The joys and the sadness. The heartaches. Because guess what? Following Jesus, being loved by Jesus, is not a cure-all. But I tell you, God's love conquers all. And when we start living out a conquered love and a conquered life, because we may not be where we want to be, we may not be in the perfect scenario, but guess what? When we find out how much God loves us, we're good in the process.
Said this one phrase that just kind of stuck with me. When we accept extraordinary love of God, we accept to live an extraordinary life. To me, that meant that I have been searching my whole life for love, satisfaction, and fulfillment. And I always thought that that love was, you know, companionship, finding a love with somebody, or seeking the approval and the love of my family and my mom and my parents, and that was gonna make me feel worthy and make me feel like I mattered. Today, I realized what I've been looking for my entire life is God's love. And that love today, I realize, God's unconditional, extraordinary love is going to fill, and it is filling, every single void in my heart that I've always been looking for or looking to fill. I know now that having God in my life is going to change everything. The love that God gives us is much more greater than you can ever fathom. I was literally standing there listening to the pastor, and chills were just all over my body. As we were saying prayer, my eyes were watering and I was tearing, and something in my heart felt so right. And as I'm telling you this, I feel it. Like, it feels so right to let God back into my life. And this time to really let Him into my life and really learn from Him and let Him lead me in the life that I need to live. Because only that will ever give me fulfillment and happiness. It changed me, and I know it's going to change my life. Now, I know it's not going to be easy. It's going to get a whole lot harder before it gets easy. Following the right path in your life that God wants us to live, that's never going to be easy. But I do know that He's with me now, and He's never left my side. And he's never left yours either. He's always been there with you, next to you, listening to you. Because yesterday when I was in that car, you know, he was there with me. He never left. He was there with me this entire year that I felt that he left and I was disconnected from him. It's a crazy thing to think that there's someone out there that loves you more than you could ever love yourself. And that... wow. To think that there's somebody out there that loves you more than you love yourself, and that loves you more than anybody else in this world could. And that he's always there for you, even when you don't have anybody. That's powerful. And the tears that I'm feeling is not tears of pain. They're not tears of... They're just pure tears of joy. And they're tears of... I don't even know what the word is that I'm looking for. But I know that as I'm saying this, I'm finally realizing that I'm not alone. I feel like I need to share this message with you because I know there's a lot of people can share what I'm feeling and can understand what I'm feeling right now. I felt so empty for so long, looking for answers, looking for a solution, looking for a roadmap, and I realized there isn't any. The roadmap and the answer to what I'm looking for is just letting the love of God, of Jesus, just come flow into my body. And that will lead me to make every right decision in my life. Things that don't fulfill you, you need to let go. The things that are empty to you, you need to let go. I feel like God spoke to me today because he wants me to share this message. And in a way, I felt when I left that church, I felt like something took over me. Like something was literally taking over me and wanting me to just share this message with every single person that I could. Wanted to shake every person and be like, oh my God, this is what you're looking for. But obviously you can't, because not everybody sees life the same way that you do. And you can just only hope that they will find God at some point in their life. So I'm literally editing this video right now and I realized that the end got cut off, or like it didn't record at all. I think the message that I wanted to share with you guys was said, and sorry, excuse my laundry. Really just wanted to share that with you guys, and I hope that somehow this video will resonate with some of you guys and help you through whatever you are going through. I'm not very good with words sometimes, and there was a lot of things that I wanted to say, but they're just so hard to say. But anyways, I think my message came across. I think his message came across, hopefully. I would really love to connect with you guys in the comments. So please let me know if you guys have experienced something like this or understand this thing that I'm going through, because I feel like it's a powerful thing and is worthy of sharing. And I would love to know your story and how you found God, or, you know, maybe if you need God in your life and you need somebody to talk to you. I want the comment section to be a support forum, and I want everybody to support each other and help each other through whatever hard times they're going through. So definitely a different kind of video. If you guys enjoyed it, let me know. I will try my best to do more of these kind of like raw videos about life, because life happens and stuff. If you guys made it this far and you made it to this point in the video, thank you guys so much for watching, for listening to me, and for being there for me, and hope that it touches something in your heart and makes you realize that, you know, God is with you. And if you are one with God and you have God in your life, God bless you. You know, it's a wonderful feeling. It's a wonderful place to be. Feeling kind of exhausted and drained right now. I'm going to put this video up right now, and I know, I don't know how it's going to do, but today was a day of very big spiritual healing. But anyways, I just wanted to say thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope you have an amazing and blessed day, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.